evening. And ladies and gentlemen, we are going to just keep it rolling, roll right on into my next guest. Now, this gentleman that I have on today, he is a critically acclaimed honey baritone. Is that a description or what? What does that conjure up in your mind? Honey baritone. He's a pop R&B vocalist serving up a musical smorgasbord of love, romance, and deep chocolate melodies for all your special and magical moments. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the Paula G Show, E. Walter Smith. How are you, sir?
I'm doing well. It's always great to be part of a packed house.
Absolutely.
So great to be talking to you this evening.
Likewise. This has been a moment in the making, so I appreciate your patience and you know, as we were able to coordinate this. And we're going to just jump right into this. You've got some wonderful things going on here, your latest music ventures and show and so forth. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Well,
share with our audience what you've been up to.
Mm-hmm. Sure. Mama's Day was a couple weeks ago, and it's the beginning of the wedding season. And so I've got an amazing song titled Little Girl that we recently produced a video for, you know, including a lot of celebrities from sports and entertainment, music, film, acting, and what have you, to kind of help to present the message of the beauty and magic of the father-daughter relationship. And so, you know, that's out now, and like I said, it serves as a great add-on for any kind of Father's Day celebration between a father and his little girl, as well as any other kind of scenario that comes up, be it a father-daughter dance or at a wedding or at a bat mitzvah or sweet 16 birthday party, graduation, just anything, you know, where a father and his little girl want to celebrate that magical moment. So, that's part of my wedding day project that's out now as well.
All right, and you know we've got a little bit of little girl, and we're going to sit back, if it's all right with you, and allow the audience to hear E. Walter Smith, Little Girl.
Do the colors of a rainbow sometimes make me cry? Daddy, when will I find my knight in shining armor? Will he be strong just like you and love me forevermore? Daddy, come to my tea party.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was E. Walter Smith, Little Girl. What a precious song.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
What a precious.
By chance, do you know any daddy girls out there?
Oh, hey, you're talking to one.
I thought you might be.
Yes, I know a few daddy's girls, and they're called daughters and granddaughters. You know, I always say the daughter has more power than the woman that birthed her. She got more power than the woman that birthed her. I'm telling you.
Oh man.
Like, when, you know how when daddy enters the room, nobody else exists.
The funny thing about this song is, you know, what kind of inspired it when my sister
mm-hmm.
got married. We're all kind of sitting around the house, you know, mom, dad, and my brother. And the room gets real quiet, and dad goes, "When your sister was born, I prayed that I would live long enough to dance with her on her wedding day."
Oh, how precious.
Yeah. You know, the whole room just kind of teared up. And
yeah.
And it kind of inspired the song because their relationship, you know, there's nothing like it. You know, she was the baby girl, and ridiculous. So,
I know, right? I know. Just, you know, the daddies are just putty. They're just putty.
Oh,
even
absolutely.
The biggest, strongest, machoest, they just putty.
There you go.
That is so sweet. It's real sweet. So tell us, okay, so what are some of the other products you got going on?
Well, you know, a lot of people tend to think that baby boomers, once they get that AARP card, they're done partying. And and I was inspired to write a song that's kind of autobiographical in nature, but, you know, technically based on there's a lot of things that people that were born, you know, people that were like 17, 18-year-old, and 17, 18-years-old in the 70s and the 80s, you know, this is the kind of song that they can, you know, probably relate to. And so it's an upbeat song, you know, if you like Bruno Mars and some of the old school bands like Earth, Wind & Fire and Commodores and Kool & the Gang, this is the kind of song that kind of is thrown back to what was happening around that time. And just, you know, covering just a lot of those kind of memories and that kind of style, but yet still making it real clear that, you know, the party's not over for them. I'm just really kind of getting started. So,
you know?
You know, kind of came together, and you know, I think that right from the beginning note, you'll be like, okay, I remember this kind of groove, but I'm ready to get down and party. So,
all right, well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to groove a little bit, Tim. baby.
I was 18 in 81, a hoop star and rock and roll. She was a ballet dancer. Was sweet, had pretty face, and ooh, a sexy style. So I took her hand like any man, go back the whole while. She said, ooh, baby, mm-hmm. But she was fine and had the mind to keep my spirit high. The gentle touch I love so much with poker on his eye. She said, ooh, baby, mm-hmm. Before, but seeing it on its way, and I'll cherish those memories forever. Next time I fall in love, I know just what to say. Yeah, next time I'll ask her to stay. Hey, hey, I'm so blessed to live another day. Still got my hair, the summer gray. Living in Atlanta, PA. Whoa, the time is right for Mrs. Wright to come into my life. Someone special, just like my daddy's wife. She said, ooh, baby, mm-hmm. So you wanna take a chance on romance, huh?
far right, running fingers through my hair. See, young folks don't know nothing about that. Young people don't know nothing about that.
Well, yeah, put a little throwback on there for you, and it's real interesting to watch the reaction that I get with that song, because you know, people that, like I said, were 17 and 18 in the 70s and 80s, they get that song, you know, in its entirety. And but if I'm playing it and I'm at a stoplight and I'm in a whose car stereo is louder battle with the car to my left, if I'm winning, they'll turn their dials and kind of start bopping their head. Say, turn that up, cuz, turn that up. So, you know. I'm hitting a couple of markets with that, and it's just a fun, upbeat song, and it has a breakdown. You know, it's a song that has a chorus, a melody, a breakdown, a bridge, and a vamp on up, which a lot of songs don't have now. So it's just a fun song, and a lot of folks are kind of starting to dig it. So
how did all this start for you?
Well, you know, interestingly enough, I sounded just like this when I was 10 years old. So I was not allowed to sing in choirs. And ended up playing bass guitar up until, really through college. But it wasn't really until 1981 when Larry Graham came out with One in a Million.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And then suddenly I felt like, well, you know what, now it's my turn. And,
right.
You know, I grew up in a neighborhood where, you know, there was a lot of, you know, rock and roll influence. I played in a rock and roll band, so a lot of the groups that I, a lot of my music influences, you know, from the beginning were like, you know, Kiss and me and Jay Giles and Bread and that kind of thing. But as time moved on, like I said, when Larry Graham, you know, entered the scene, at least entered my life, everything kind of started to change. And then from there, you know, I started, you know, singing in choirs and developing the voice, and then, you know, moved to Atlanta and began writing songs and collaborating with amazing producers that, you know, are on songs that you're listening to now, and directing musical, directing bands of groups that you see on tour right now, and the discography and the production work just kind of continues to grow, and
right.
You know, I'm just doing what I can to kind of fill that void that many people are talking about, and offering great, you know, quality music with great production value, and making sure that the message is you know, family friendly, but yet, you know,
right,
current enough to, you know, to be competitive, basically, and you know, but at the same time timeless, because you know, if you've got a great song that's talking about love and romance, you know, regardless of, you know, you could be hip hop, you could be old school, you could be AARP, you could be, you know, going into the, you know, seventh grade having your first kiss. You know, if the song is time, you know, talking about love and romance, there's all, at some point there's a place for it. And
there is a place for it.
And I've got a lot of songs for, you know, for those special moments.
Yes, and ladies and gentlemen, if you are logged on listening to the show, or even if you're not logged on listening to the show, you can go over to E. Walter Smith, that's EWALTERSMITH.com. He's got a wonderful website and just a plethora of information and opportunities that are available for you to experience this honey baritone sound of E. Walter Smith. I like that. And, you know, you're so right, because, you know, no, I'm not dissing the music of today. Howsoever. that 70s sound, that the you know, with the lyrics, when you really listen to the lyrics, you know, when y'all start singing to us back in the 70s and the season. Oh, Lord have mercy. Anyway. Anywho.
Well,
but yeah, you're absolutely right. There definitely is a need for, you know, that old school music and those sounds and those vocals.
You know,
I mean, real vocals.
A lot of people have no rap or no game at all. And, you know, if they can find the right song to speak for them, then they have, you know, that's the way that they create their love life. That's the way that they, you know, present, you know, their romantic side. So, you know, to be a part now of somebody's playlist or be, you know, the voice for those people that are trying to create that moment is an honor and a responsibility that I don't take lightly. And like coming up next, you know, I've got my song "My True Love" that really speaks to that, you know, where you know you got a person that you know is madly in love with somebody, and opening line is "I can't imagine waking up without kissing her goodnight. Her morning magic, all I need to start my day off right." And, of course, you know, the big question is, what is morning magic to you? Now, depending on who you ask, it could be walking up behind your woman as she's cooking breakfast in the morning. It could be how they woke up in the morning. Magic is as magic does. But the bottom line is you're not trying to set a scene or create an atmosphere or create an environment where, regardless of what you think romance and love is to you, you can interpret. You can make your own interpretation of what I'm presenting to you and make that moment, you know, very magical. And then, of course, the chorus of the song is, "A true love is a miracle that's built right from the core of your heart, your soul, your dreams, and things you never knew before. It's natural, not demanding, orchestrated from above. Like the air I breathe, you're all I need, my true love."
Ladies and gentlemen, E. Walter Smith, "My True Love." Now, Walter, you know what they call that type of song back in the day.
What do they call that type of song, Paula G?
That's that baby-making music song. That's that baby-making music.
Well,
"My True Love," ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, I do my part. Thank you.
To populate the earth, right?
Yeah, well, you know, I do my part. I do my part.
But, you know, in addition to your music, you also do some voice work as well, some voiceover.
Yeah. I've done everything from bumpers for radio spots to TV commercials to, you know, do a lot of like PowerPoint presentation. The voiceover work for that, keynote addresses, like the radio spots, product placement kind of stuff. And, you know, it, really when I first got into doing voiceover work, I was actually invited to do some of the reading for the blog, like with the guest that you just had on. And it's really been a thing where once I realized that, you know, I kind of had this voice that it seemed to, you know, like a little bit. It keeps things, you know, pretty interesting. I'll say that.
Yes, it does. Now we're getting short on time, so I want to make sure that we get this last song and tell us a little bit about the bride slide.
As you know, it's the wedding season, but the truth of the matter is that people get married every single day. And you know, like I know, if you go to a wedding at some point, there's going to be some kind of line dance. And I've been to enough weddings where there's everything from and everything else, electric slide. So I came up with the bride slide. And I got the amazing Lavoria Reese to, you know, be my wife on this particular song, and then I got Lady Faye, who is an amazing hip hop artist and choreographer, to do the rap for me, and it's the bride's line, and it's being played all over the world right now on several stations, you know, like in Europe and Germany now, and also locally in the South. It's catching my fire down here as well. And the more and more people hear it, the more and more there's a place for it, and there's a dance for it. And, you know, people just having a good time with Bride's Slide. So.
All right. Well, they're about to hear it now. Ladies and gentlemen, the Bride's Slide.
Bride's Slide.
That's a nice little jam there at a wedding. Bride, so I can see the bride in her wedding dress just getting it.
There you go. And the dance itself is simple enough for the four-year-old that's either the ring bearer or the flower girl to the great-great-grandmother. So
yeah.
I try to make it, you know, enjoyable and fun for everybody. So,
yeah.
We got three versions of it, too, so. If you go to ewaltersmith.com and click on wedding, you can hear all the wedding music and all the different versions of that song.
Yes. And is there anything you'd like our audience to take away from this conversation? Anything that you'd like to share that you haven't shared yet?
I just want to say, you know, first of all, thanks so much for having me. And that if you are a fan of just great music with a great message, and always, you know, having a place for love and romance in your heart, please visit ewaltersmith.com, and check me out. You know, I've got all kinds of music there and videos of both, you know, some of the cover stuff that I do, you know, with like my legend shows like Barry White and Lou Rawls and some of the older, the other baritones, and a lot of new stuff. So just go check out ewaltersmith.com. Click on any of the buttons and, you know, pull on your seatbelt, get ready to have a great time.
Yes, and he's got a lot here, ladies and gentlemen, on his website, Soulful, Wedding Day, E-Live, music videos, voiceover, the legend. So make sure you check this gentleman out because he's got some great music, some baby-making music. He's got some great music. And it just, you know, it's just good quality music. So I really appreciate you and just thank you. I wish you the best, just much success. May doors of opportunity just open for you. So thank you so much for being with us, ladies and gentlemen. E. Walter Smith, right here on the Paula G. Show this evening.